Hey, what's up, everyone? And once again, welcome back to Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, the Booster Course Pass. Last time, we finished up Wave 4 with the 200cc Boomerang Cup, and this time we're heading into 150 once again for the next wave. We have some new characters right here. We have Petey Piranha, the one character that I wanted back, and he's right next to King Boo on the roster. Double Dash homies back together again. Wiggler, my absolute favorite character from Mario Kart 7, and Kamek, a first timer here, not counting Tour, who was originally going to be in Mario Kart 64, so that's really exciting. We're going to be playing as all three of these guys, of course, starting off with Petey Piranha. This is my boy right here. I have been looking forward to him being back in the game. Okay, as for what we're going to put him in, honestly, I want to see this dude on a bike. Look at him go. Because Petey has only ever been in Double Dash, which is sad. You know, I think he deserved to be in more games, personally, and I'm very glad that he's here. How about we just give him the regular sport bike? I want to have handling up a little bit because this dude's a heavyweight. Honestly, regular wheels. And then we could have... We want more acceleration or more speed? Probably more acceleration. Because, again, heavy guy. And more traction. We'll go with the parachute. Alright, and we are taking on the 150cc Feather Cup. Look at that, Goombas in the same slot across two cups. With Tour Athens Dash, GameCube Daisy Cruiser, yes, finally some more Double Dash representation, Wii Moonview Highway, and a brand new course, Squeaky Clean Sprint. Let's do this. Okay, so Tour Athens Dash. This one, I think, was only added recently. I don't believe, I don't believe that this has existed for very long. So it's essentially a brand new course in and of itself, which I think is very cool. Oh, Petey. Peter, my guy. I'm so glad he's here. I am so excited to play as this stupid flower man. Look at him go. All right, I am... Oh, I love him. I'm very prepared to lose. Like, I'm super prepared to lose here. Oh, there's a shortcut off to the left. Okay, good to know. Very prepared to lose. Very prepared to have to replay this a couple of times. It's been a hot minute since I've even played Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, if I'm being honest with you. It's been an even hotter minute since I've used an inside drifting bike, because I normally use the... I normally use karts in this game. King Boo's up in front with us. Look at that. He's probably programmed to be Petey's rival, which would make sense. We got a half pipe. Let's take it. Why not? Yeah. Oh, okay. Oh, left. Yeah, I believe each character is programmed to have one or two rivals who will always be, like, really close by them, like, in the second and third positions. King Boo makes sense for Petey because he was his partner in Double Dash, so it's just really nice to see them both together in the game. Oh, God. Oh, we're going up a sand hill right here. Green Hills, look at... Anyway, that looks like a shortcut right there. So Athens Dash, from what I'm aware of, is, well, like I said, brand new pretty much. But it's also not really a city track. Like, it doesn't feel like London Loop or LA Laps or anything like that. LA Laps is in this wave, I think. Maybe... I can't remember. Is LA Laps... One of the other... Whatever. It doesn't feel like the other tour... courses, you know, this just feels like a regular course because it's all like off-road. You're not just in the middle of a city, and I really like this. And oh, look, rocks, incredible. Excuse me. Oh, don't hit me. Oh, the red shell. Oh, okay, so it looks like Dry Bones might be our other rival. I know King Boo is like King Boo's an almost, like, definite shoe-in for, yeah, okay, he's the standard rival. And we're about to lose to said rival. Okay. I'll be right back. Oh, not again. Not again. Don't blue shell me. Goomba! Oh, no. That freaking Goomba messed me up. We're fine. I think we're fine. Also, is King Boo not in the race this time around? I just realized... Oh, no, he is. He just fell back a little bit. Okay, so of course you didn't get to see that race, but whatever, I go first. Yeah, cool. Daisy Cruiser. Now here's a course that I am all too familiar with. This is of course from my favorite Mario Kart game, Mario Kart Double Dash. It's also appeared in Mario Kart 7. Also, Kamek's in the race this time. I don't believe he was in last time. Maybe he was, I don't know. Welcome, Fiddy-Koo, to the race. Let's do this. So it is open on both sides here, like it was in 7. In Double Dash, you could only go off to the right. We can, of course, go through the pool in this version. We don't have to go all the way around it. God, God, classic. Oh, the music. So Daisy Cruiser was, in my opinion, kind of a shoo-in. I fully expected this course to be in the Booster Course Pass. Because it's one of the most popular courses from Double Dash. And it's also already been in 7, and I believe it's also in Tour, if I'm not mistaken. So it's like, yeah, it's probably coming back. Let's take the left path, why not? But I'm happy it's here. Would I have preferred, like, DK Mountain? Yeah, probably. But I still think that we're going to get DK Mountain, if I'm being honest. I don't want to just be doing, like, predictions and speculation in these videos, but we've only had 2 Double Dash courses across 40 DLC courses so far. That is a horrible ratio, and I, for one, don't like it. So I'm really hoping that the final wave gives us 2 Double Dash courses. I'm hoping for it. I think it could happen. And I think, oh, I'll get rid of my Bob-omb, my god. I think it could be either DK Mountain or Dino Dino Jungle. And I'm gonna be bold here, and I'm gonna predict Bowser's Castle from Double Dash. I don't think we're getting Rainbow Road at this point. I think we're getting Wii Rainbow Road, but I could see us getting a Bowser's Castle, and I could see it being the one from GameCube, because that one is really good, and it's never been brought back. Side note, can you tell that I'm familiar with this course? Because we have been front-running this entire time and had absolutely no issues. Good job, Petey. He's also not using the same voice lines as Double Dash. I think he might have the same hurt animation or hurt sound, but I believe these are new voice lines. Maybe not new for this game, but they're definitely new from Double Dash, so that's good. Next up, Moonview Highway from Mario Kart Wii. It's been so long since I've played on this course. Because I let's played Mario Kart Wii in like 2011, maybe 2012, I forget exactly when. It was my second Let's Play, so it's been a minute. And I think the last time I played Wii was the whole effing show that we did in 2014, right before the Wi-Fi servers shut down. I don't think I've played the game since then. So this is exciting. I like Moonview Highway. It's not my favorite Wii course. I think there's better Wii courses that could be added. Just one of them is in the next cup, spoilers. But it's certainly a good one. It is certainly a good one. And I believe that this is the only course in the game that has the bomb cars on it. Like, the bomb cars that have been driving around here, I believe that they just had to entirely make those for this. Look at that. Look at that thing. It's massive in this game, too. Yeah, I believe that had to be made exclusively for this course, so it's nice that they're putting a little bit more effort into these. If you go back and you take a... That was a bomb car. If you go back and take a look at the first wave of DLC versus this one, the fifth wave, you can definitely see that the quality has gone up a little bit. These courses 100% still feel like they're just ripped out of Mario Kart Tour, but compared to, like, Toad Circuit from Wave 1, I think the quality has gone up substantially as the waves have kept going. And then, of course, they also added characters, so that's also gonna up the value of this Booster Course Pass, I have to say. Speaking of characters, I'll probably save it for the next race, but we only have 2 slots left, and I'm a little scared that we're not going to get some fan favorites because it's only 2 slots and there's more than 2 fan favorites. So we're absolutely not going to get everybody that everybody wants unless they do a second pack, which I don't see him doing another booster course pass. I don't see them doing another course pass. But a booster character pass, I can absolutely see happening. So I was taking a shortcut there. I thought I was just driving up a wall for no reason. That went surprisingly well. Anyway, Squeaky Clean Sprint, a brand new course, which I believe is coming to tour as well, but Nintendo considers this a Nitro course, so here you go. I guess it's technically a Mario Kart 8 Deluxe course first. I guess, I remember back when we did the first wave of DLC, and I was really confused about Ninja Hideaway. Maybe that was Wave 2, I forget. Wherever Ninja Hideaway was. It's because it got added to Tour at, like, the exact same time, but Nintendo considers it a Nitro course, considers it brand new for 8 Deluxe. So that's why it doesn't say Tour in front of it. I thought that was, like, an error with the prefix. It's not. Nintendo just considers it a brand new course. I considered it a Tour course. Even though I guess it technically was brand new because I hadn't played Tour, so I didn't even realize. Also, we're in a bathroom. I don't know if you noticed that. We're just flying through a bathroom right now. This music is banging. I love it. Yeah, turn your headlights on there, PD, so you can see. But this okay. Lakitu's out for blood, or maybe that was Larry. I don't know who had the bob bomb. Either way, we got two laps to catch up now because we are struggling. Of course, the retro courses, the returning ones that I'm familiar with, are the ones where I did all right. Not here, though. Not here, though. You can actually go on the sponges up there, it looks like, but I haven't really had the opportunity to do so. Heading through the drain. A green shell. Okay. There's a little shortcut off to the left there through that ring. Interesting that there's a fish in the drain. Oh, God. And also, this has, like, not this purple right here, but this floor has, like, ice physics, because I guess it's supposed to be, like, a slippery bathroom floor. Trick off of that. Is this an upper pathway? Yes, it is. Up on the shelves. Okay, next to the hairdryer. And a light bulb for some reason. God, this is cool. I like the Bitty Buddy clock. That's really nice. And then there's just cassette tapes right here. I drove straight into that banana. I don't know why I did that. Also, I got zero coins, so this is great. You have to take it very sharp in order to get onto those sponges right there. Come on, Petey. We have to win this because this is the last race of the cup, and I would like my triple star ranking for the video. I would like to not have to replay this if that is okay with you. You know what? Maybe it's not ice physics. Maybe it's the fan. Is the fan actually blowing us back there and, like, simulating ice physics? That would be really interesting. Oh, no! Okay, it's fine. It's fine. They updated it so that you don't lose your glider when you get hit by lightning. That was updated a little while back, and it's a very nice inclusion. Come on, Petey. I think we're fine. Yeah, okay. I thought that there was someone behind us, but no, we're good. Okay. Wow, King Boo did not do good that time around. He was our rival in the first one and then just got destroyed in this second attempt. Either way, though. Oh, he's on the sponges. I don't know if there's any benefit to going on those. Anyway, we did it. And it's freaking Petey Parada. It really said, let's choose the one race that you didn't show, and we'll make that the highlight reel. Also, you may have heard, when PT got hit by the blue shell, he made the pain noise from Double Dash. So they do include some of his old lines, which I think is a very nice little inclusion. Anyway, folks, with that is going to go ahead and do it for this episode of Mario Kart 8 Deluxe. Next time, we're going to head in as not PT, but I don't want to click on the Wiggle Boy just yet. We're going to be taking on the 150cc Cherry Cup. So, If you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like, and of course, let me know what you thought of it in the comments section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.